Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. I am Muhammad Ashraf Malik. And the basic purpose of making these videos is to guide you people in the domain of pronunciation of English. So you may say that it's an English pronunciation guide. So, सबसे पहले दुआ है कि अल्लाह ताला हम सबको अपने हिफ्ज़ो अमान में रखे. अल्लाह ताला इस मुल्क को और इस पूरी दुनिया के इंसानों को अपने हिफ्ज़ो अमान में रखे. Now we begin. In English there are 26 letters or alphabet, and these 26 alphabet can give us 44 sounds, and total sounds of English we can say that are 44. It means that one letter can give us more than one sound. And among them we have 19 vowel sounds and we have got 25 consonant sounds. And we already know that among these 26 English alphabet, 5 letters are called vowels and the remaining 21 are classified into the category of consonants. So these letters, or sometimes these combinations of letters, can give us so many different sounds. And it may happen that one letter can give us different sounds, more than one sound, and different letters or different combinations of letters can give us one sound as well. And first of all, we like to talk about O sound in English. And among these 44 sounds, one sound is O. And this is the phonetic symbol for O sound in English. And as we know that one letter can give us different sounds, that's why we have devised phonetic symbols. They tell us which letter gives us which sound. Like G may give us the sound J, and it can also give us the sound G. And for this very purpose, to distinguish between these two sounds, we have developed the phonetic symbols. And we have a different phonetic symbol for J sound, and we have got a different phonetic symbol for G sound. So this is the phonetic symbol for O sound. And in Urdu, you may call it Soti Ishare, Awazon ke Ishare, which definite letter or combination of letters will give us which sound. Now this O sound we can have from many different ways. Like when AU, these two letters come together, they give us the sound O. When AW, these two letters make a combination, most of the times they give us the sound O. And when OR, when these two letters make a combination, so this combination also gives us the sound O. When AL or ALL, when they come together, mostly they also give us the sound O then. And L is the combination for this A to give it sound O. And sometimes OO, when these two letters come together, they may also give us the sound O, like DO, PO. And sometimes OU, when sometimes these two letters come together, they may give us the sound O, like P, OU or PO. And BROUGHT, brought. So there are so many different ways we can have the same sound. And A, in certain cases, A can also give us the sound O. So there are some R controlled vowel sounds which give us the sound O. Like A can also give us the sound O, like in, you can say, wo, walk, talk, stalk, choke. Now we begin with AU sound. When AU, these two letters, the combination, this combination occurs or comes in the beginning of the words, like August.
ogre, Oriot.
Here you can see that ATE is underlined. So whenever ATE comes as a suffix or giant joins any other word as a suffix, so it behaves differently as far as pronunciation is concerned. For adjectives and nouns, so it most of the times it gives us a sound ut, and here it is Oriot, not Oriate. When it is verb, it gives us the longer sound eight. Oracle, authentic, author, auto, audio, audit, audition, Auckland. Now here you see L-A-N-D, land, that is underlined. So when land joins any other word as a suffix or any other combination of letters, so lens becomes learned and gives us the sound learn. This is Auckland, not Oakland. This is Auckland. Although there are some exceptions to this rule. Audacious. C-I-O-U-S, you can see that it is underlined. C-I-O-U-S, when it comes as a suffix, is at the end of a word. When it comes, it gives us the sound shus, not shias. Auditor, augment, autumn, aura, oral, open, autism, audacity. And now you can see ISM and ITY, these are underlined. And this is not ism now, this is ism. And this is not itty, this is utty, audacity. And we'll talk about this ITY pattern as a suffix in the coming lectures. When AU, this combination occurs in the middle, we have got so many words: cause, hole, ford, pose, close, door, fraud, exhaust, note, noty. And you just remember it. If you give a slighter change, if you call it naughty, the word, it will be a different word. So that will refer to this word naughty. So just slightly by opening the mouth, by a slight change in the pronunciation, you change the entire meaning. This is naughty, daughter, source. And AU, when it also comes in the middle, coke, don't, onslaught, assault, caution, caustic, laundry, goes, sauna, cauldron, taunt. So this is it. There are numerous words, countless words, which have AU in their spellings, and there are very few exceptions to this rule when AU come together, but they are pronounced differently. Like we have got the exceptions for AU, and this word is art. It is giving us AU here, it is giving us the sound A. Art, and this is laugh. Again, AU is giving us the sound A. And this is draft. Again, it is giving us the sound A. And this is gauge. And here AU is giving us the sound A. And here we have got O sound from the same combination of these two letters AU. That is tow, chauffeur, aubergine, aubard, and otter. So we can see the same combination of OU has given us different sounds. And as for these examples, so it can also give us the sound O, and these words may also be counted among the exceptions. Austria, Australia, Aussie, because. Austere, laurel, and laureate, and laureate. And again you can see that ATE is underlined, so I have pronounced it at, not eight, laureate. So this is for today's lesson, and I have told you about the combination of AU. When these two letters come together, most of the times they give us the sound O. And in our upcoming lectures, we will talk about all these combinations, and we will also bring them together as well. Thank you.